I'm Kevin Hogan, president of Rock Island Auction Company, and as always, it is my distinct pleasure to welcome you to our upcoming December 1st, 2nd, and 3rd Premiere Firearms Auction, our last sale of 2017. This sale, in terms of the numbers, is going to be our largest auction to date. In terms of the quality, it's right there. Named collections include a selection of fine arms from the Robert M. Lee Collection, the Vern Burning Collection, the Warren Webster Collection, the Gillespie Collection, the Bruce Canfield Collection, and so many more. Whether it's U.S. military, German military, Colts, Winchesters, you know, as the saying goes, and I've been saying it for many years, it's quality in quantity. And the two guns that I want to talk to you about in this video are two of the flagships from the Winchester genre. They are benchmarks in their own right for their respected models, and they're also benchmarks for their historical pedigree. And so the first gun I want to talk to you about today is a Winchester 1873, one of 1,000. You know, when we started in the early 90s, I can't tell you how long it took to get traction, to be able to offer up some of these world-class pieces. And so whenever you have the opportunity to handle a one of 1,000, to see a real one of 1,000, it's an absolute pleasure. This is right up there with the best that we've ever seen. Brought to you, of course, by the Robert M. Lee Collection, we have a 1873, one of 1,000. And you know what sets this apart is its condition, but it's also its configuration. And when you're talking one 1,000s rare in and of themselves, you know, they say they made 720,000 1873s. They made approximately and sold 132 1873 one of 1,000s. You know, how many have been identified? Tough to say, numbers vary, but let's just say half. And so again, a benchmark for any Winchester collector. But then when you dive into the configuration of this gun, it's one of two. One of two, one of 1,000s, half octagon, half round, button mag, case hardened, 4X wood. Not two, not three, 4X wood. And it's the condition that really sets it apart. Again, I'll roll it in the light here. You'll see the case hardening. You'll see the niter on the loading gate. Beautiful inscription, one of 1,000. Gold beach front sight, beautiful engraving. And then the historical pedigree. This gun was discovered in 1953, so it would have been slightly after the Universal Movie Studios search. But nevertheless, going back to 1953, it was in John Wood's collection. Of course, now it's in the Robert M. Lee collection. And then I don't normally lay out the paperwork, but you know, look at the old envelope. Here's a letter from 1953 when it was first discovered. A letter from 1977 to John Woods. It's as good as they get. It is absolutely as good as they get. A one-gun tour de force absolutely transcends. I collect Winchesters. I collect Colts. I collect U.S. military. A one-gun collection, and it is absolutely one of the best. Not only is it one of two half-octagon, half-round, 4X wood sling swivels, we also sold the other one for $402,000 several years back. So it's a one of two, and I can assure you the other one is not going anywhere anytime soon. So from the 1873s, we'll move to this 94. A factory engraved, gold inlaid, B-carved wood. But again, what makes it truly special is its letter. And again, I don't normally out the paperwork, but I've personally never seen a Winchester letter like this. As we know, Winchester letters can leave a lot to be desired. They leave off a special order feature that you know is factory, and this thing is a laundry list of what this gun is and where it went. This was the Winchester 1894 factory exhibition display gun for 15 years, going back to 1903. We can date it to the Pan American Exhibition. We can date it to the Louisiana Purchase Exhibition. And there's a dozen more. Man, this thing has seen the world. And if you think about the time, you know, 1903, all the way up through the end of World War I, and the gun is absolutely spectacular. Factory engraved in a semi-relief, gold inlaid, beautiful carved wood. It's signed, John Ulrich, very pronounced. And of course, it's in the details. If you see this gold leaf here on the underside, I've never observed that before. You have to really dive through the Winchester engraving book to see something like that. A beautiful ram, again, almost in semi-relief. And then the actual pattern itself is, I would say, non-typical for John Ulrich. You see that vine and grape leaf motif, truly as good as they get. And then you dive into the special order features, engraved like 1/1000, rapid taper, half octagon, half round, gold bands. It really, really sets itself apart. And again, with the letter, it goes back to the Norm Flederman collection. And it's funny, it's an old listing, and he lists it as, of course, the 94 that saw the world. There is a Boutte rifle marketed just underneath this in his catalog. It was $22,500. This was priced on request. That's how special this gun is for a 94. Again, factory engraved, factory gold inlaid, John Ulrich signed, and it's been around the world. For provenance on this 1894, you're not only talking about the Winchester factory letter, but it was also part of the Mac McCroskey collection, a name synonymous with the best, especially when it comes to Winchesters. Two flagships from our Winchester genre that we'll be selling, of course, December 1st, 2nd, and 3rd, and so, so much more. We're gonna do some more videos on Winchesters. We'll look at Colts, Smith & Wesson's, sporting guns. You're gonna hear from a number of our different staff members here. We're very, very proud of what we have coming up in December. We hope you'll be as interested as we are. Again, it's December 1st, 2nd, 3rd. Don't forget the preview date, November 30th. We always make it fun. We always make it enjoyable. We always make it a party. So we'll have our live preview party on November 30th. Come see these great guns and so many more. For more information about Rock Island Auction Company, visit our website, www.rockislandauction.com. Like us on Facebook, follow us on Twitter, and subscribe to our YouTube channel. Looking forward to seeing you in December.